Happy Friday, folks! Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Talking Freight, the weekly freight and transportation management series brought to you by Sarasys, the transportation management company, where we talk about best practices, tips, trends, and ways to more effectively manage freight spend and transportation process. Now, you might notice a slightly different angle in today's video. That's because we're now doing videos standing up. That way I can move my hands more, and this video is much more fun to watch. We'll see how that goes. But in today's Talking Freight episode, and we thank you for joining us, we continue our full truckload series, this time talking about one of the hottest issues in transportation today, procuring a full truckload in tight capacity. The use of full truckload shipping is rising in popularity, resulting from its lower cost as compared to less than truckload, or also called LTL shipping. Unfortunately, the use of full truckload shipments and expenditures have hit an all-time high. These rates will have natural implications for smaller shippers seeking to lower overall transportation and freight spend, and paired with a blurred lines between peak shipping and shopping seasons, shippers will experience increasing trouble when trying to procure full truckload capacity. All right, so let's talk about how shippers can better procure full truckloads in tight capacity. First, what's the problem? Well, capacity woes are finally becoming a reality. Full truckload rates are rising in demands to tight capacity, with some companies experiencing a 35% year-over-year rate increase. Industry-wide, rates rose 25% in January of 2018 alone, and spot rates, those rates involving full truckload shipments that do not recur, are starting to exceed contracted rates. Unfortunately, this means small and mid-sized shippers, who are already struggling to maintain profitability in logistics and shipping, will face additional struggle in attempting to procure full truckload capacity. Thanks to an increasing capacity crunch, spot rates will remain super high for the rest of the year. Fortunately, a solution exists. So what is that solution? Well, shippers must use out of the LTL box strategies. Shippers must take a more strategic approach to truckload procurement. Economic and market activity show few signs of slipping, save for a minor tumble in economic prowess earlier this year in February. In the past, shippers may have ignored provider complaints attempting to time the market to take full advantage of truckloads and engaged in relatively minimal interactions involving full truckload procurement. This strategy is ineffective in the long run, and shippers must use the following out of the LTL box strategies. Number one, communicating fully and accurately details of shipments in need of full truckload transport. Benchmarking progress and use of all transportation modes. Conducting annual procurement exercises and leveraging a web-based and constraint-based bidding tool, such as a transportation management system. You may consider hiring outside experts to help manage both inbound and outbound freight, such as hiring a 3PL like a Sarasys. You've also got to stay attentive to the market, and if you're able to, vary available full truckload carriers, but retain a smaller set of frequently used carriers and drivers. Now, this final aspect of the solution, it can be difficult to grasp. If a shipper wants to vary available carriers and drivers, how does it also focus on working with a specific set of carriers instead? Well, the answer lies in outsourcing the process to procure full truckload shipping availability and capacity. And depending on the 3PL chosen, outsourcing may also include the use of that software as a service platform known as a TMS, much like our very own Raider. In fact, working with an outside entity is integral to accessing much of available capacity when trying to procure full truckload shipping. 89% of carriers have fewer than 5 trucks, just 5. So expanding the number of carriers and drivers a shipper works with is tantamount to accessing 89% of available capacity. So when you've implemented the solutions that we've talked about here, what's the reward? Well, procuring full truckload frees capital for other uses in your business. In today's market, Customer service is everything. Customers will not hesitate to abandon purchases in favor of better costs and shipping options from a competitor. And shippers must have the capital available to help ensure e-commerce visitors and potential buyers make the conversion to actually purchase. In other words, shippers need to have the capital available to market their products correctly. For example, content marketing, which we do here at Sarasys, is integral to every brand seeking to build better relationships with customers. Depending on the type of product sold, content marketing can range from publishing a steady stream of blog posts to keeping Instagram and Facebook followers engaged. By lowering freight spend and learning how to procure full truckload capacity, shippers can effectively divert capital from logistics to marketing. In turn, more marketing will enable a continuous growth, creating a self-propagating cycle. Free capital can also be used for any number of other reasons, such as product research or testing, development, and more. So in summary, figuring out how to procure full truckload capacity, hey, it's not that easy. It's no small task. But from Amazon to local truck drivers, the full truckload capacity crunch is at epic proportions. Getting a handle over freight spend through access to more truckload capacity is the ultimate win-win for retailers seeking to stay competitive with the big box retailers, and of course, with Amazon. Now that's it for this week's episode. We hope you have enjoyed talking freight as you do each week. We'd love to hear from you. If you have a question about anything related to freight, or even about Sarasys, or heck, maybe something about marketing, we'd love to help you out. Leave a question right down here below with some comments. Hey, and you know, we're on social media, and we'd love to engage with you. It's a great place to find all of our content. So make sure you come over here, connect to our social media platforms, and we'd love to have you. Don't like to get on social media, or you just like to get emails? Well, we can send all the content via email right to your inbox. Anytime we have a new blog post, we'll send you our new podcast episodes. We'll even send you each episode via email here about Talking Freight. So if you go to Sarasys.com and you scroll down about 50% down the way on the page, you'll see, just as you do coming up here on the screen, a little box. Put in your email and hit subscribe, and we'll make sure you get all of our great content. Oh, and I forgot one of the most important things. Right now you're watching a video here on YouTube, but hey, you may not go back to YouTube again. And you really liked this video, and we know you did. So hit that like button. That would really let us know what kind of content you love. But even further, hit that subscribe button, and then you'll get a little bell icon that you can push. If you hit that, you'll get a notification every time we publish an episode each Friday of Talking Freight. That way you won't miss a single one. Well, thanks again for showing up and watching us each week here on Talking Freight. We really appreciate it. As always, we'll see you next Friday.